in a world like none other, there comes one man in search of plastic, in search of cons. He is known as Plasticon. Join him as he brings toys from another dimension to a household near you.
Hey guys, welcome to another Plasticon thing. I wanted to chime in and talk about dinosaurs. Not you, dinosaurs. No, out. Dinosaurs, as in monsters. Monsterverse. You know, Godzilla. Yeah. These could be a nuisance. Anyway, I wanted to chime in and talk about the Transformers and Godzilla crossover. Thank you. Anyway, let's go ahead and get into this thing. Wanted to swap over here and show you guys exactly what I've actually been talking about. At the Tokyo show that's coming up this weekend, we actually got a sneak peek of a couple of the Godzilla Transformer crossovers that everybody's been raving about. And probably not raving in a good way, and kind of upsets me a little considering I'm really a big fan of Godzilla. I'm a huge fan of Transformers, and so, you know, these things kind of go hand in hand for me. And you. So, what we're going to take a look at here is what is upcoming. As you guys can tell, we got the Laser Prime mold that I've actually reviewed twice. And it's an excellent mold. A lot of people are not happy with the fact that it's fully gray, that's got a little bit of blue, and like the crazy kind of a, I don't know, almost a military-ish green for the trailer. I'm actually a fan of this. I think it's amazing. I'm game. Taking a closer look at the actual truck itself, it's not bad. I like the fact that the cannon on the back is actually blue. That matches the truck and this whole kind of a digital, I don't know, kind of like a digital camo type of thing going here where it's almost like scan lines. It's very interesting. As you guys can see, Prime's back here and he's got the Godzilla insignia here on his chest. And it's got the kanji there. And this is actually supposed to be Mecha Godzilla. Now, to give you guys a little bit of a look at Mecha Godzilla, Mecha Godzilla itself is a huge gray robot, grayish silver, with these huge blue pieces on his shoulders. The same thing with the guns. The guns are blue as well. So if you look at the Optimus Prime, it is literally the same thing. This is a really, really, really good take on the character, although some people would expect a little bit more out of it, to be honest. When they invest so much money in trying to make a mold like this, they're going to get their money back easily. The other thing I like is the fact that the windows are actually yellow, which harks the yellow eyes that Mechagodzilla has. Same thing with the weaponry. The weaponry is also yellow, if you guys notice. Yellow sword, he's got the yellow axe. I'm pretty sure the eyes, we'll end up getting closer looks at this, are probably going to be yellow as well. I'm a huge fan of it. I'm one of the ones that's actually supporting this because I want to see more of this kind of thing come out. This is Godzilla crossing over with Transformers. We didn't think this would ever happen, but it has, officially. Now let's talk about the Godzilla itself. The Godzilla is pretty neat. He's got some really, really gnarly like tattooing and such going on throughout it. It's not just a black kaiju. It's actually got some detail to it. Yeah, it is the Grimlock mold. It does have the blue neck, but to be honest, it's kind of harking that whole, like, where Godzilla powers up to do his fire breath, and it's amazing. I love the fact it actually comes with flame effect, because these little practical effect parts are amazing, and it really helps with telling the story of what you got going on there. Yeah, it's kind of silly how the gun just snaps onto the back, but I mean, that's no fault of this toy. That is fault of the Grimlock toy. So, to take a little closer look at the robot mode. Robot mode, pretty solid. I like it. That's a solid toy. It's been a solid toy ever since it's come out. I like the idea it says Godzilla on the front. Some people have been saying, oh, this is kind of like, you know, Megatron, just cosplaying as Godzilla. I'm not against this. I think it's kind of funny. It's cool. It's got a new head sculpt. They've actually put a little bit of time into it. Some people are saying it's kind of lazy. I personally think the idea of the claws being gold is really nice. Really, really thrills back to this one little toy. And this toy came out in the 80s. It's a straight knockoff of Grimlock. But this knockoff company decided to redo some of the bits and pieces of this, which, you know, if you look at it, it is a full, entire different mold. Even the front arms on this thing are articulated, but it is straight Grimlock as Godzilla, which is kind of funny. And honestly, I'm okay with this, but it's a knockoff. This was not an official toy. This being an official toy coming from Takara is nice. It's nice to see this. I'm a big fan of this, and I am highly supporting this. What do you think, Derpasaurus, where'd you go? What do you think? Cool. Yep. He thinks it's cool, too. I'm a big fan of this. I think we need to have more of this in the entire community. I know some people are not the happiest with it, but to be honest, I happen to be the minority. I've always the minority in a lot of this stuff. I'm into this crazy crossover stuff, and I'll end up getting into more of the craziness that I like to get into and tell you a little bit more about this stuff in the future. But you guys, if you don't support this, there won't ever be any more crossovers. I would like to see a Rodan. I would like to see a King Ghidorah. I would love to see, I don't know, Jaguar. That'd be awesome. And tell me you guys wouldn't like to see these as Transformers as well. So if we don't support this kind of thing, it will not continue. So go out there, support these things. They may not be the perfect thing, but as far as I'm concerned, this is amazing. And I can't wait to see the boxes these things come in, because the box is going to be pretty cool. And I kind of hope this comes as a two-pack. It'd be nice if it came as a two-pack. I don't know about you guys, but it'd be nice to see them bundled together. Probably not, but, you know, it is what it is. So, this has been Plasticon. This has been Derpasaurus. And we'll catch you guys later as I play more coming your way. That's it for now. Bye! If you like this content, please like, share, and subscribe. I also have YouTube membership and Patreon, so feel free to sign up for those. I'll be doing shout outs on those for those who donate toward the channel. Thank you all for your support, and I appreciate everybody that has been taking their time out to support the channel and check out what I do. This has been Plasticon. This is me signing off. Peace out, y'all. See you around. Bye.